we'll start this thing off right. Raider! Man, I've been waiting all my life to do that.
I'll say, even though we had our chance to win this, I'm still bummed that we lost it. Like, I think having our chance to win it kind of made it harder. I don't know. Brooks, initial thoughts here. What's your immediate reaction to this game?
Find out, you know, early this afternoon that you're going to only have 7 guys. And so you're kind of like, hey, you know, not really sure what to expect from us. No, we're going to fight, but you're on the road at a hostile environment against the top 15 team in the country, team who's played Baylor pretty close there over the weekend. So you're just kind of like, not sure what to expect. You struggled to score. You looked pretty damn awful on the offensive end. Lots of turnovers, sloppy play. Lots of mistakes, couldn't hit open shots, couldn't get open shots. And it's just another one of those games that's really frustrating that you're sitting here at the end thinking that we should have won. We should have won that game. And despite only having 7 dudes, despite missing your 2 best players, you gave yourself a chance to win. If you can make free throws, you win this game. If you could learn to finish some layups, if you can learn to hold on to the ball, some of those things, you win this game because you played a hell of a game defensively from all of these guys. But ultimately, you know, you couldn't hit the shots when you needed to. When the game got down, you know, to the end, you couldn't get a fucking shot off to save your life.
Yeah.
So some very frustrating moments throughout this game. And it's just kind of another one to add to the list.
What are your initial kind of reactions to this game and how they fought and being in a hostile environment? Initial kind of thoughts after this is over?
I mean, the first thought I had was Iowa State is overrated.
Oh, yeah.
I don't mean that in a bad way. I think they're actually a really good basketball team.
Yeah.
But they're not the 11th best team in the country. They're just not. And I think that was proven tonight when you just laid it out, right? Like, you don't have Terrence Shannon Jr., who's an all Big 12 player. You don't have Kevin McCullough, who arguably is an all Big 12 player. You don't have Malik Wilson, who I don't think people get enough credit for how good he is. And how desperately you needed a point guard. Biggest thing tonight for me that I learned just from a Texas Tech point of view, and maybe it's an overreaction, but Clarence Nadolny should be the starting point guard for this team moving forward. Whatever he brings offensively, fine, whatever. I don't really care. You have to have a guy that runs point on this team. There's not a guy that, I mean, at least with Malik Wilson out, I feel comfortable running it, because you think about it, Kevin McCullough is not a point guard. Terrence Shannon isn't a point guard. Adonis Arms isn't a point guard. Like, you need those guys off. Yeah, exactly. You need those guys off the ball, making cuts, running backdoor, going off of screens, moving. And when you have those guys as your primary point guard, the offense is just stagnant. What's the difference between this year's offense and last year's with Mac McClung right now? Nothing. Yeah. There's no difference. Nothing different at all. And tonight, yes, I get it. It was stagnant at times too, like whatever. But you're also down everybody and their mother at this point because of COVID injuries, whatever it may be. And I thought Clarence Nadolny played pretty well. And the biggest stat for the night for me, outside of maybe Kevin O'Banner having 10 rebounds, was Clarence Nadolny turned the ball over 0 times.
Yeah.
0 times. Yeah. And he played 36 minutes. By the way, shout out to Adonis Arms. He didn't come off the freaking floor tonight.
No.
Yeah.
40 minutes.
Past 3 weeks.
Yeah. I mean, Adonis Arms is a GOAT, in my opinion. I love everything about him. I loved him when he transferred in, but I didn't expect this. Like, I thought he was just going to be a good role player.
Yeah.
But that man's a stud. But yeah, I think for me, the biggest takeaway is Clarence Nadolny should be the starting point guard for this team. He's a little reckless sometimes. But my biggest fear coming into tonight was, can he control an offense and not turn the ball over? He did just that against the team in Iowa State. They're good. They're a top 35 team in the country, in my opinion. And their defense is legit. And you don't turn the ball over, that'll play. that'll play. Also, 40% from the free throw line. What the hell are you doing?
40% from free throw and 17 from three. We did not do ourselves any favors. I mean, get your initial thoughts out there, man. You've been a little bit kind of overshadowed there. What you got going on?
I mean, after the first half, I didn't think this is going to be any kind of game. And so, very impressed with our second half and how we fought and played defense and made them shoot horrible. And we actually showed some offensive life at some points, right from like that 8 to 3 minute mark in the second half.
Yeah.
Some buckets and some backdoor stuff and some layups, some dunks. And then we forgot how to play offense the last 2 minutes there. But I really just think that free throws, you know, they were our Achilles heel tonight in a worse way than normal, but they're going to be our Achilles heel all year. And we're only shooting 67% for the season as a team.
That's yeah.
What about if I told you that's like an improvement from last year, though?
Good.
Damn.
Improvement from last year.
67 is bad. And yeah, 3 for 17 from three, but. To your best three.
That's not an improvement from last year. For 17 is not an improvement.
But I mean, you did what you did to Tennessee and muddied it up enough and rebounded well enough, stayed in there. And I'm surprised you had a single digit game for most of the second half. Had it within four for a lot of the end of the second half, and even got up by two. Props to those guys and the coaching staff for making this game work well enough. That you don't feel too bad about this loss, really.
Yeah, I sounded pretty down like when I was talking about it earlier, just because I fucking hate losing, man. It sucks to lose, and it sucks to lose a game that you felt like you played well enough to win. And it sure well didn't look great. Like, it was pretty damn sloppy, but that's how we know we're gonna have to win a lot of these games, is muddying it up. But yeah, you got to commend the seven dudes going out there and battling and giving yourself a chance to win. So I don't want to seem like I'm bitter at these guys. Like, it just sucks to lose a game where, you know, hey, if you make some free throws here, you do this there, you make this layup here, you win.
I'll keep you for one more for two more quick questions, and then I'll let you get on your way. Let you get to bed, dude. I appreciate you hopping in here with us.
I'm an old ass man. I'm an old ass man.
I don't.
Like, you're like probably way younger than all of us here.
Yeah. No, probably not.
I'm 35. All right. So.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. I am younger than that.
I got some gray hairs and shit, and each one of them is starting to.
Is everybody 30 here except for me?
I think so, actually. Yeah. You might be the youngest, sir.
31.
Oh, okay. I turned 28 this year, so there you go.
Come on.
27.
Damn it!
You still got 2 years.
You still be playing NCAA basketball,
sir.
Finally. Yeah, no. I mean, I have 4 years of eligibility left. Still.
Be on that Perry Ellis track right now.
Yeah, exactly. Hopefully not the balding track though.
So let's not shame that. All right, my head's hiding back there.
Why you wearing hats?
Catch y'all at the next tailgate.